Hi, this is Natalie and
Valerie.
With the Fifth Journey, we're going to make soy wax tarts as well as soy candles, and she's going to help me with them. So we're going to use goggles for her, and then we have some gloves to help protect us. So make sure that you have safety first. We have a thermometer because with the soy wax, we don't want it to get too hot. You're going to use a double boiler. You can use a makeshift one. So what we did, I just have an old pan, and this is a can that I bent and made a little bit of a funnel with, because once we're done with this, I can't use it for anything else, so I will throw it away. You'll want to have your pure soy, and this is, we've already done a few of them, but this is about 3.5 pounds. You can get them in different packages. And then on your fragrance, you want to use about, so for a 3.5 pound package of soy, medium strength is about 2.8 ounces, and then a strong scent is about 4.8 ounces. Make sure that you are using a fragrance that is safe for candles. And we are going to be using a really nice harvest apple fragrance. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to melt down the soy wax, and we have the thermometer again, and we're going to do a few wax tarts. And I have some done already that we did previously. So you just pop one of these out and put it in one of your warmers. And then after that, we are going to fill a couple of candles. So the first thing we're going to do is carefully, we're going to put these into that. Yes, let's go ahead and put your goggles on. And then I'm going to have you put on a glove. Another big. Is that gonna work?
Yeah.
Kind of, sort of? Okay. Once you, I'm gonna pull this closer to you. Okay. Can you pick some of these up and put them in there? Just a little bit. Just a little bit at a time. Okay. Now be careful not to drop it in the water. Get close to the bowl. There you go. Now don't drop it. We don't want to splash. Oh, see how that one splashed in there? See what happens is when that splashes in there, then it melts. Now, you don't do this, so I don't want you to burn yourself. So make sure you're doing this with an adult. Okay. Can you put some more in?
Yeah.
Very carefully, just a little bit at a time. A little bit at a time. There you go. Put your hand right over there. Put it in there. There you go. Some more. There we go. Good. And drop that down. Now you want to make sure that you're covering everything with wax paper, because that makes it a whole lot easier to clean up. And without. And drop it in. Put your hand closer and you don't want to splash. I know that glove's big. If you're able to find kid-sized gloves, that makes life a lot easier. Okay, put your hand closer. There you go. I'll drop some more on there. Okay. And get some bigger chunks. Cool. Now, with the wax that's fallen in the water, once it cools, you can just break the wax off and remelt it. Go ahead. Now, I've already been heating the water, and there's already some wax in there that we've been heating up to speed up this process, but it does take some time. Go ahead. To heat up the wax, and you don't want to do it too hot, because depending on the type of wax you're using, like if you're doing beeswax, they all have different flash points, which basically means if you get it too hot, it can catch on fire, which you don't want that to happen. I just spilled in there too, didn't I?
Mm-hmm.
That's okay. So with the soy wax, you want to melt it to about 170 degrees, and one of these infrared thermometers is really handy. So after putting that in, we're only at about 100 degrees. We're going to use a long stir stick to stir it. So we're about 130 degrees. And I'm going to go ahead and put the, you put one more handful in? Okay, we're going to do a little handful. Go ahead and leave those on.
Okay.
Just in case, because we don't want you to get splashed. All right. There we go. Okay, and I'm gonna go ahead and put this back over the heat. You can hear that water's simmering and I've turned it down. I've got a long stir stick. Can you reach that to stir it or no? Okay. So you want to have a long wooden stir stick that you're not going to get too close to the heat. Go ahead and give it one more little stir. Good. And we're going to wipe the sides off. Now make sure that you have either, if you're making a makeshift double boiler, you need to have something between the inside container and the outside pan, because otherwise this would be on direct heat. The double boiler part, the water wouldn't matter at all. So I have a silicone, it's kind of, you can use it as a pot holder or a trivet, but you can also use it in these pans. And you can use, I've done shims before, or you can use a thin cookie cutter, whatever you want to do that works for you. Let's go ahead and take this off. Okay, so the next thing we're gonna do to get started, I've already done these, but when you're putting the wick in for candles, you can either glue them down, or what I like to do is actually get the wick, the little metal part, dip it in the wax, and then put it in there, and then it's all hard. So what I'm going to have you do, I'm going to go ahead and pull this forward again. Let's put the goggles back on. Okay, so you're going to do is you're going to dip it in there like this.
Okay.
And then you're going to pick it up and place it right inside there, okay? Go ahead and take it. Keep your fingers out of the way. Don't drop it. Dip it in there and then pick it up, and then you're going to put it right there. And we're actually going to do it a couple times because you want to drip a little bit of wax in there. Okay, so we have some wax in there. And then can you thread this through?
Yeah.
And that's going to hold it upright. Okay, now don't pull it up though. Good, so it's right in the center. We're gonna do it one more time with this one. There it is. Just nice and straight, okay, go ahead and dip it in. Okay, dip it in. Is it good in center? Okay, let's go ahead and set those out of the way. And then we're gonna slide this back over. All right, can you give it a stir? Go
ahead
and put it on there and stir. Good job. Kind of hard and you can't see it. Okay, scrape it on the side. Go ahead and set it right there. And we'll see how warm it is. It almost melted. So we are at 120 degrees, so it's actually gone down since we've had it off, but it's good and melted. Doesn't mean that you have to get to 170 degrees. That's just the max point that you want to be at. So you don't want to go above that. Now when you're adding in the fragrance, you want to be no more than 165. See how it's almost melted?
Yeah.
Yep. So there's a few little lumps left, and then I'm going to go ahead and do the pour part. That's something you don't want to do just yet.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah. But you can put the fragrance in. So we've done about half of this already. So we are going to be putting in about an ounce of the fragrance oil in this. Sides, we're almost done. I'm going to show you real quick on the camera. Okay, keep your fingers out of the way for a second. Now we have to use this. Okay, and this is very, very hot. So you can see. Do with that. There we go. See how it's melted? There's no lumps left. Okay, go ahead and give it a stir again. Just a few. There you go. Good job. Okay. Yep, gently scrape it. And set that over here. Okay, we're going to have you go ahead and put the fragrance in. So that's all melted. All right, keep your face back. Let's go ahead and put this on. Just in case it splashes. All right, you're gonna pour it with your right hand. Can you do that?
Yeah.
Okay, now don't pour until it's right over that. Okay, now make sure you stay away from the heat. Pour it right in there, keep our faces away. And then pour it all in, and this will drop the temperature of the wax. Okay, go ahead and give it a stir. Now again, do not do this unsupervised. Make sure you have an adult with you. Nope, keep those on. It's too close to your face. There we go. I'm gonna let that set just for a second, and I'm gonna bring this over. So as you can see, here's an empty one, and you can either fill it up, so depending on the kind you have, there's little cavities, so you can fill it up just to the bottom of those cavities, or you can fill it up more than that, so I just filled up to the bottom of the cavities. That's about 2 ounces of wax, and all the way up is probably about 2.5 to 3 ounces. So that one's already done. Got my heat turned off. All right, you ready to watch? Can you just gently hold that in place? Lay those on. Now these are kitchen gloves, but they do have some heat protectant in it. I just sit down and do this one first. Okay, now just hold it right there with the glove, just a little bit. Good. Get this out of the way. I'm gonna do one little cavity at a time. And you'll need to let these sit out probably 8 to 12 hours. And the nice thing about it is when you spill on this wax paper, it's not a big deal. You can just clean it up afterwards. Right, I'm going to slide this one out of the way. Okay, hold that one down.
Yeah.
Good job. And it's kind of like ice cube trays, so when you pour it in, it fills up the one next to it. And that one's done. So that took no time at all. Slide this one out of the way, and now we're going to fill the candles. Pull that up. Okay, let's do the little ones first.
Okay.
Now, what I actually want you to do is I want you to hold this up straight.
Okay.
Very, very gently. Okay? Fill it up about 3/4 of the way full. Okay. Slide that out of the way. Okay, let's go ahead and do this one. Pull that up very gently and I don't pull on it. Okay, go ahead and grab it. Now when you're doing this with the glass, you want to make sure that you're using candle glass that is can withstand the heat. You don't want to just get thin glass because that can shatter and it can break. Now, if you're doing a hotter wax, then you want to use a heat gun and actually heat up the glass a little bit before pouring your wax in, because just like I'm pouring something into cold, a cold glass, it can shatter it. Okay, go ahead and hold that one up. Ready?
Yeah.
These will make good Christmas presents, won't they?
Mm-hmm.
And this one we may fill the rest of the way up.
One.
Actually, you know what? I'm going to probably save this wax and put it in a tart, a wax tart. Now, if you're wanting to fill this up all the way to the top, the wax as it cools can make a little bit of a funnel in the bottom. And if it does that, then you'll want to let it cool a little bit and then add more wax to the top. But for now, we're done. We're going to go ahead and let those harden, and then we'll come back and see what they look like. What do you say?
Yeah.
Yeah. You think so?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, sounds good.
Okay, you see how the candles are finally done, and the, what are they called?
They're called wax melts.
And the wax melts are done. As you see, once you take these off, the candle will still stay up, and you see there's some littles, and if we trim these off like that, those candles could be smaller.
Mm-hmm. And they'll be ready for gifts, won't they?
Yep.
Yep. And then we have the wax melts already, aren't they?
Yep, the wax melts smell good. They look ready to go.
Mm-hmm. Should we go ahead and trim these off?
Yeah.
So you see you want to have them about a quarter inch tall.
Yep.
We're going to cut it right. There we go.
So it'll there.
Take a lot longer. Yep.
And we're going to package these. We're going to shed them and put some stickers on them.
Mm-hmm.
And these are really good to sell when you're ready to sell. If you want to sell them, you can. If you don't, you don't have to. Thank you for watching, and I hope you watch next time. Bye.